Hello and welcome to another Warframe video. In today's video, we're going to take a look at Valkyr. So let's get started. So to get base Valkyr, what you need to do is do Themisto on Jupiter. This is also one of the easiest way you can get neural sensors early in the game. To get Prime Valkyr, what you need to do is get some relics that are specifically on Railjack. Same thing for next Prime as well. Build for that will be coming out soon as well. So these are the two ways you can get Prime Valkyr or base Valkyr. You can also feed your base Valkyr to Helmet System to get Warcry on other frames. So taking a look at her abilities, her passive isn't that useful because when you have Hysteria on, her fourth on, you're basically immune to knockdown, so it's pretty much useless in my opinion. Even if you don't have Hysteria and you have Handspring or you have Prime Show for it, still becomes really pointless, so not that much fun passive, but decent if you don't have either of them. Ripline is basically like a gimmick in my opinion. If you hit it on an enemy, it pulls them towards you. If you hit it on ground, it will pull you towards the location of it. Totally gimmick. I would recommend to subsume out this ability rather than Paralysis. I'll show you why. Warcry, so what it does is in your modded range for modded duration, you get increased armor, you get increased melee attack speed, and the enemy movement speed decreases as well. This does work well with Gloom, but not sure you want to use it because you basically want enemies to come towards you or you to go towards them and melee attack them and kill them really easily. But put on some strength, you will have increased armor, you will have increased melee attack speed and decreased enemy movement, so that's a really good one as well. What Paralysis basically does is knocks down enemies nearby you. It drains 33% of your shields, whatever you might have at the time. So if you want some breathing room on Valkyr, this one is decent for it, but not really that useful as well. Most of the time you're going to be using Hysteria and Warcry. So coming to her fourth, that is Hysteria. It brings out Valkyr's talents and it has energy drain as well on this, but it is a powerful exalted, so highly recommend not subscribing. Zooming this out. It also gives you invincibility as long as you're using the talents. If you switch out the weapon to a primary or secondary, it will stop using Hysteria. It will stop the energy drain, but you will be vulnerable. You will take damage during that time. So whenever you're using Valkyr, try not to use any other weapons. Just use her talents and Warcry. So that's the abilities. So what you can subsume on her first? Well, Nourish is one of the options. What it does is it gives you damage increase on Vital as well. It gives you energy multiply as well, so you can pick up more energy. It also gives you a little bit of damage, so that is a really good option. What other options you have? You can put on Roar for increased damage. Eclipse I wouldn't really recommend because it does really depend on your lighting conditions, but that is a good option as well if you can manage the lighting issues. Like at Hunt with Combat Discipline, the build we're gonna see in just a bit, that one really works as well. Along with that, Silence works really well on that one as well because you're going to be dealing melee damage. You can have low range and you can kill enemies really easily. Also, what Silence helps with is the Acolyte not using the abilities, even with the X-Miss as well. So you can have Silence on that one as well. It works really well. So let's take a look at the build now. So taking a look at the first build, that is Avenger and Lycanth Hunt build. Combat Discipline in the order slot. The reason we're using Combat Discipline is to trigger Arcane Avenger. On damage, it's a 21% chance. You can get 45% additional crit chance. So that's the reason we're using Combat Discipline. Preparation, just in case I have some skill issues and die, whenever I revive myself, I will get up with maximum energy, so that's the reason I'm using that one. Blind Rage and Intensify for ability strength. Prime Continuity and Narrow-Minded for duration. The reason I'm not using Max Narrow-Minded is because I don't want to lose the range. I want to have a decent amount of range, that's the reason I'm not using it, but you can try it out as per your taste to see what works best for you. Rolling Guard on dodge, we get Invincibility for 3 seconds and Seedless Cleanse as well. This is just in case our Hysteria dies down for whatever reason, it's only there for that reason. Prime Flow for energy max. Equilibrium, so since we're using Lycanth Hunt and Combat Discipline as well, so whenever we get melee kills, the Lycanth Hunt will have a 50% chance drop of health orb, so that's the reason to manage health and energy as well, we're using this one. Eternal War, whenever we get melee kills, it has duration to Warcry, that's the reason we're using this one. On the current build that I have, it gives me 4 additional seconds per kill I get on my melee. And of course, Energize for energy. So taking a look at the second build, which has Nourish. Steel Charge in the auto slot for melee damage. Doesn't matter really, but it gives us additional mod capacity. That's the reason I'm using it. Blunt Reach and Transient Fortitude, along with Umbral Intensify for ability strength. Prime Continuity and Narrow-Minded for duration. Rolling Guard for status cleanse. Prime Flow for energy max. And Eternal War to get additional duration on our Warcry. I'm using Prime Fury on this one. It gives us additional melee damage on critical hits. Since I'm not using Avenger, that's the reason I'm using this one. It's another good option that you can have on Valkyr, since you're doing mostly melee damage anyway. And again, Energize for energy. I don't have a rank 5 Fury, that's the reason I'm using rank 3 only on this one. So taking a look at the third build now, that has Silence. Steel Charge, again, the aura slot for melee damage. Handspring, I'm using this time because I do have the option to have this additional mod, so that's the reason I'm using Handspring. You can use Prime Shift for it, but I don't feel it's much useful because if you're using Valkyr's talent, that is Hysteria, you don't even need it because you are basically immune to knockdown during that time. Blunt Rage in Transient Fortitude for strength, Prime Continuity for duration, Eternal War again to increase Warcry's duration per melee kill, Rolling Guard for Cedar's Cleanse invincibility for 3 seconds. I'm using Streamline this time because Warcry and Silence, both of them drain a lot of energy, so that's the reason having a little bit of efficiency helps with it. Prime Flow for energy max, Umbral Intensify for ability strength as well. Arcane Fury for melee damage on crit hits, and Energize for energy management. So taking a look at the talent builds, Prime Pressure Point for melee damage, Prime Reach for range, Gladiator Might and Augur Shadow for crit damage, Sacrificial Steel for critical chance, Quickening, I'm using it to get additional combo count chance, that's the reason I'm using it, not for attack speed, and Electricity and Toxin to get us Corrosive. So that's the Corrosive build. And if you take a look at the Toxin build, most of the build is the same, just some change, Electricity for Drifting Contact for Cedar's Chance and plus additional 10 seconds of combo duration. I'm also using a stat stick just to have Gladiator mod set on there to give us additional crit chance per combo multiplier. Minded that we're not using this weapon itself to build the combo multiplier, but rather we're using Valkyr's talent itself for combo multiplying. Also, special thanks to SinoXYZ for answering a lot of Valkyr related questions for me. You can check it out in the link in the description below. So here we are in the Simulacrum to see how Valkyr's abilities work. I'm going to activate Hysteria and I'm going to activate Warcry. You can already see the enemies are slowing down and we're just going to slide attack. That's the best way to deal damage with Hysteria. I'm also going to show you how Paralysis works. Basically, it stuns the enemies and if they're lighter enemies like Elite Lancers, they're going to get knocked back as well. It does drain your shields, but it doesn't matter really too much. Also, the white ring you see around Valkyr, in case there are some enemies in the ring, what it'll do is whatever damage you've absorbed, it'll give you the damage itself rather than not dealing damage at all if you don't have any enemies in that range. So that's the thing. Like I said, to deal the damage, the best preferred way is to slide attack continuously. That's the best way to do it rather than just beast attacking the enemies because the slide attack is a bit slightly faster. So yeah, let's get to Steel Path. That is it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you found it useful. If you did, be sure to leave a like, share with your friends. Comment if you have any questions. Subscribe for more Warframe content. See you in the next one. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.